Good morning, my dear students. Our today's topic, transpiration. In the plant physiology lesson, this transpiration is the last simple part. This word transpiration is not new to you. Already you have discussed well about this transpiration in the lower classes. Anyhow, let us know something more about transpiration. Where does this transpiration occur? Yes, you all know this occurs in plant, right? Already we discussed about photosynthesis in the previous class, right? For the process of photosynthesis, we need chlorophyll, water, carbon dioxide, and sunlight, isn't it? Only with this the plant can prepare food by the process of photosynthesis. Do plant require photosynthesis means? Yes, it is must. So only through the process of photosynthesis plant can prepare food, isn't it? So water is very very essential for the process of photosynthesis. Okay, and now when you pour the water, the water is sucked by the root and the tissue called xylem very much involved in this transportation of water to all the parts of the plant. Right, children? Okay, so what happens to this water? So the absorbed water is supplied to all parts of the plant. So this water is used for the process of photosynthesis. And the excess of water is released out from the plant. This is what we say it is transpiration. So what is transpiration? The loss of water in the form of water vapor from the aerial parts of the plant body is called as transpiration. Very important 2-mark question, children. The loss of water in the form of water vapor. So water is lost from the plant. That is, excess water is lost from the plant in the form of water vapor. Okay, this is called as transpiration. And for this transpiration, we should know there are three types. So there are three types of transpiration. What are the three types of transpiration? Stomatal transpiration, lenticular transpiration, cuticular transpiration. Right, so let's discuss about these three types of transpiration. So excess of water is lost from the plant part, isn't it? So what are the parts of the plant? Root, stem, leaf, isn't it? So from through all the parts of the plant, the water is lost. The water, the excess water is released or removed from the plant. That is what we are going to discuss now. First is what? Stomatal transpiration. Stomata. What is stomata? Yes, the tiny openings in the leaf is what we say it as stomata. So the leaves have tiny and also microscopic pores. What is pores? Holes is a pores. So that is microscopic. It means the holes can be viewed only through the microscope. That means very minute, very small holes are there in the lower part of the leaf. And that's what we say it as stomata. And water is evaporating out. Already I told you water evaporates out through the form of water vapor, right? So the water evaporates through these stomata. Where is it present? It is present in the lower part of the leaf. Stomata structure is given for you. Okay, so here the openings in the leaf is what we say it as stomata. And each stomata is surrounded by the God cells. Can you notice in the picture? So this is stomata and each stomata is surrounded by what? God cell. Okay, and these God cells help in regulating the rate of transpiration. How does it regulate? It opens and closes. So the stomata is opened and closed By the help of what? The God cells. Where is it present? See, this God cells are the supporters, not supporters, protectors of the stomata. What is stomata? The tiny openings. So this stomata is closed and opened during the process of transpiration. So when it is opened, the transpiration occurs. When it is closed, the transpiration does not occur. You understand, children? So this is maintained by the God cells. So what is surrounded by God cells? Yes, each stomata is surrounded by the God cells. Now, altogether, I want to tell you here the leaves are having a tiny pores, that is microscopic pores, and that is called a stomata. So if the water is lost from the plant through the stomata, it is called as stomatal transpiration. This is one type of transpiration. And one more point is to be noticed here. 90 to 95% of water is transpired from the leaves only, right? So that means what? Most of the transpiration process is occurring through this kind of stomatal transpiration only. And then there are two more types of transpiration. Sorry, children. There are two more types of transpiration: cuticular transpiration and lenticular transpiration. Now let's discuss about this cuticular transpiration. Here it means what? The transpiration is occurring through the cuticle. What is cuticle? Yes, the waxy layer of the plant is what we say it is, cuticle. So the type of transpiration is responsible for the loss of water in plants, that is through the cuticle. The water vapor directly diffuses through the cuticle on the leaves and escapes to the atmosphere. So cuticle is what? Here the new word is what for you? That is cuticle. So the cuticle, you can notice in this picture. Most probably the outermost layer of the leaf contains what? A waxy coating. If you sprinkle water, the leaf won't absorb this water, right? Yes, the water will roll over this leaf. It never gets absorbed by the leaf. It's due to what? Yes, due to the presence of the cuticle, that is waxy coating. So here through this also the water gets transpirated. And that's what we say it is cuticular transpiration. And next type is what? Lenticular transpiration. The lenticles are nothing but a tiny opening that protrude from the bark in the woody stems and twigs, as well as in other plant organs also. Especially you can see this picture, bark part of the plant. Yes, the stem part. The stem part after growing into a tree, it becomes thicker. The stem part becomes more and more thicker, and that's what we say it as bark. So the bark part of the tree has got what? Lenticles, minute or tiny openings in the bark part or trunk part or stem part, we can say. The woody part contains openings called lenticles, and through this also transpiration occurs. And that's what we say it is lenticular transpiration. This type of transpiration is the loss of water from plants as vapor through the, remember this word children, lenticles. And next, so now we have discussed about three types of transpiration. What are they? Stomatal transpiration, cuticular transpiration, and then lenticular transpiration. Now tell me, is the transpiration necessary for the plant? Transpiration is what? Loss of excess amount of water from the plant parts are released out to the atmosphere in a form of water vapor. This is called as transpiration. Is this transpiration necessary? Yes. It is very, very important for the plants. Why? This only creates the pull of water in leaf as well as stem. Continuously, the water is absorbed by the plant from the soil, right? So, for that absorption, what is required? This transpiration is required. If the transpiration occurs only, the pull of the water takes place, right? And secondly, the absorption, the process of absorption of water from the soil with the help of root takes place very actively only by the process of transpiration. And also, continuous supply of minerals also takes place. So, water as well as minerals are absorbed from the soil. So, this for the process of absorption, transpiration is necessary. And this water absorption is maintaining, or this transpiration is maintaining the proper temperature in the plant. So, water is absorbed by the root and then that is applied to the plant, and thereby excess water is released by the plant, which we say it as transpiration. And this transpiration is very, very, very important for the plant for these reasons. So, temperature is maintained, continuous supply of mineral and water is done to the plant. Absorption, normal absorption of water as well as mineral is taking place continuously in the plant due to the process of transpiration. So, transpiration is necessary. They may ask you, is the transpiration necessary? Why? Give the reason. They may ask you. So, and also that is very important question. And the types of transpiration also we have discussed now. Now, let's know about the exchange of the gas. Do gas exchange takes place in the plant? Yes. Do we exchange gas in our body? Yes. So, we take in oxygen and give out carbon dioxide, isn't it? While breathing, we take in oxygen and give out carbon dioxide. That's what we say it as respiration. So, for the process of respiration, this exchange of gas is required. Already we have discussed about this in the respiration process by the humans. Now, if you take for the plant, plant also respires. That means exchange of gas is taking place in the plant also. Plant also uses oxygen. That is, take in oxygen and gives out carbon dioxide in the process of respiration. Okay, but what about the photosynthesis? Photosynthesis means what? Preparation of food by the plant. So, for the process of photosynthesis, what gas is required? Carbon dioxide. So, from the atmosphere, plant takes the carbon dioxide and gives out oxygen in the process of photosynthesis. Right, children? Can you understand? There are two processes in the exchange of gases. One is respiration, another one is photosynthesis. So, this respiration as well as photosynthesis are simultaneously occurring in the plant. So, here what are the two gases involved? Oxygen and carbon dioxide. As children, listen carefully. In the process of respiration, plant needs oxygen and gives out carbon dioxide. Respiration takes place throughout the day. Right. But photosynthesis takes place only in the daytime. Right, children? So, photosynthesis is what? Preparation of food by the plant. So, for the process of photosynthesis, you see to the arrow carefully, carbon dioxide is taken in the process of photosynthesis. The plant takes the carbon dioxide from the atmosphere and release out oxygen. So, that's why we are getting the fresh air with the help of the plants. So, plants take in carbon dioxide and gives out oxygen during the process of photosynthesis. But at the same time, if you take respiration, plant uses the oxygen which is prepared by the plant in the daytime. Not only that, in the nighttime, it takes the oxygen and gives out carbon dioxide. So, this process of respiration as well as photosynthesis takes place simultaneously in the plant. So, two gases, carbon dioxide and oxygen. So, for the process of photosynthesis, carbon dioxide is required. It takes carbon dioxide in and gives out oxygen. In the process of respiration, it takes in oxygen and gives out carbon dioxide. Right, children? And then, this photosynthesis can only occur during the sunlight. So, I told you, during the daytime only photosynthesis occurs. And what about the night time? Night time photosynthesis is not going to take place, isn't it? So, the plant makes use of the oxygen from the atmosphere, isn't it? So, during the night time, more amount of carbon dioxide is released from the plant. That's why It's not advisable to sleep under the tree at the night time. Why means photosynthesis is not taking place. Only respiration is taking place in the night time. So plant takes all the oxygen from the atmosphere and it gives out carbon dioxide. So if you sleep under the tree during the night time, what happens? More amount of carbon dioxide will be released by the tree, so that there is a possibility of inhaling carbon dioxide. So it's not good to sleep under the tree during the night time. But what about the daytime? During the daytime, this is not going to happen, isn't it? So the plant undergoes photosynthesis. Due to that, it takes only carbon dioxide and gives more and more oxygen. So this is happening during the daytime. Right, children? So nothing harm to sleep under the tree during the daytime. Yes, children. So now we have discussed well about exchange of gases, which is taking place in the plant. So with this, we are coming to the end of this lesson, plant physiology, children. So in today's class, we have discussed about transpiration as well as exchange of gases. Thank you.